An epic rescue just in time. Now, President Trump's pick to be the next U.S. Supreme Court justice was on Capitol Hill today, hours after his selection was revealed on primetime TV. Brett Kavanaugh met with the Republican leadership, who'll guide him through his Senate confirmation hearing. Democrats have vowed to fight his nomination, fearing that he could turn the court in a more conservative direction, especially over abortion. But Republicans do hold a narrow majority in the Senate and hope to confirm him before November's midterm elections. Joining me now is Ron Bongean, a Republican strategist who helped steer Justice Neil Gorsuch onto the court. So, Ron, with the benefit of your experience, is getting Brett Kavanaugh confirmed going to be more or less straightforward than it was with Neil Gorsuch?
Well, we're off to a great start. Kavanaugh had a wonderful nomination ceremony last night, an excellent speech. Outstanding delivery. Not only did he talk about his deep experience as a judge, but also his personal experiences as a family man. I think he is off to a great start. But you know what? It's a marathon, not a sprint.
And as you know, Democrats are throwing everything at this because this is the key swing vote on the court. So it's going to be tough, isn't it?
Well, you know what? Republicans hold the majority, even though it's a smaller majority. And, you know, Gorsuch was confirmed 54 to 45. This will be probably a little bit tighter. There were three Senate Democrats in red states that voted for President Trump that supported Gorsuch last time. I think we may pull one or two of those, maybe all three of those this time around, because the confirmation vote will be closer to the election.
But here's an interesting thing. Last night when he was speaking, Brett Kavanaugh was very much reaching out to women, wasn't he, and promoting almost his feminist credentials. Is he trying to win over those key moderate Republican female senators who are especially worried about Roe versus Wade?
Well, what's fantastic is that he told a story which just happens to be true. That's exactly who he is and how he's lived his life. It definitely benefits him to be sharing that with senators who are watching, such as Murkowski and Collins, that do have concerns about Roe v. Wade. Also, video footage has surfaced of his previous confirmation hearing between him and Chuck Schumer, where he said that Roe v. Wade was Supreme Court precedent and that he would not be going after that. I think that made them feel a lot better. Also, he was the least controversial of the four picks Donald Trump had narrowed his list down to, and I think that made them feel good as well. They gave positive comments, and I can see the trend is moving in the right direction.
And yet, the Senate Majority Leader, Mitch McConnell, who must deliver the votes, warned the president that Kavanaugh would be more difficult to confirm than a couple of the others because of his paper trail. So that has to be a concern,
doesn't
it?
Well, the reason why is, and that's why it's a marathon, not a sprint. There are more than 300 rulings that Kavanaugh has presided over that they're going to pour through. Not only that, but he served in the Bush White House. So there are any emails, any documentation, anything can come out at any time. While he's had a strong start, he's going to be visiting with dozens of senators, Democratic and Republican, taking questions from them, and that information will be revealed time after time about how he's answered questions regarding all sorts of things.
Ron Bongean, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Now, President Trump is in Europe right now, where he'll make his first visit to the UK's president and sit down with Vladimir Putin in Helsinki. First up, though, is the NATO summit in Brussels, which could be overshadowed by Mr. Trump's comments on how NATO members must pay more towards their defense.